Hello. My name's Kyle Mikolajczyk, and I'm the current head projectionist at Lens and Lights at Worcester Polytechnic Institute in Worcester, Massachusetts. And today, I'm going to show you how to use this EIKI EX-4000P 16mm projector, and I'm going to show you the operation and threading and usage. Let's go. All right. The first thing to do is take off the cover and place it somewhere. In this case, I'm just gonna throw it over here. Next, what we do is prepare the projector for usage. So we take this take-up reel arm, fold it out. We do the same thing to the front one. We fold it out, then it should click in. This projector is getting old, so sometimes it doesn't click in properly, but we just leave it in that general area. Next thing we do is turn the power switch on, and once it's on, we also make sure the projector next to this is a dual projector operation, is also turned on, because we want access to the changeover switch. And once we have this, we can prepare it and put film on it. We grab a take-up reel, which is stored underneath this projector, and we make sure we place it into the back hole. In this case, we make sure not the circle end, but the square peg goes away from you. As you can see up here, we have a square peg right there. So we simply stick it on here, make sure it locks in, and close the tab, and now it's free spinning. Next thing we do is grab some film. In this case, I have a 30-second Kool-Aid ad that I found on eBay a few years ago. Absolutely hilarious, and we get to use it here. We take this, we open up the film until we have the leader coming out, and we want it to hang on the right side. See, this is correct, this is incorrect. This is correct, this is incorrect. When it's hanging down on the right side, we can stick it onto the other one over here. And I'll demonstrate. Once it locks in, we simply close the tab, and what we then do is pull enough film until it goes over the cabinet and hits the floor. Now, of course, if you're not using our projectors, this is just a general idea, but basically you want, I don't know, about 2 yards of 16mm film for your to be threaded up successfully in this projector. All right, once we have the film reel locked on, our next step is to start threading it up. The threading up can be a bit difficult, but we're going to go through it, and by the end of this, you should be an expert. What we do is we take the film that we've pulled out, and we want to put it through the first spot right here. So we open this shoe. I'm going to call it the shoe. I don't know if that's the correct term. I'm going to call it a shoe. Open the shoe, and you pull it down until it clicks. What we then do is loop it in there. So we take the loop. We put it in. And once it's in, what we want to do is lock it on these little sprocket holes. It's a little hard to see in the camera, but basically there are these, from the sprockets, they want to lock in so you can actually feel the sprockets. And once it's good on both sides, we close the first one. And now we can even tighten this up a little bit to spin it counterclockwise, tighten it up. Once we have this, we next care about the upper loop. This is what we call the upper loop. So for the upper loop, what we want to do is pull the focus knob, which is this big knob, and we pull it towards us. And you'll feel it click out, and now it's aimed directly at the camera. What we then do is we take the film, and we want it to run smooth across. And I'll probably put in some shots of this from another angle or two as I'm doing this, because this current angle is a little bad for the camera, that is. But basically we line it across this little metal plate that was hidden by this lens. Once it's lined up by that, we want to make sure the loop goes flush against the base of this. As you can see, put it across there, roughly touches it. Good. Now that we know that it's across the plate, we lock it in. Now we move on to the sound area. The sound area, what we do is we take the loop that the film that came from through the lens. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna put it onto this next shoe right here. Same thing from above, make sure the sprockets are through the hole, and close it. Now, important here, we need to check that this flywheel here is moving freely, and it is, and we need to make sure that it is not rubbing against the metal. Now, in this case, mine is rubbing against the metal, so I'm gonna shift the film over one sprocket. We're gonna advance it one sprocket. Now it's too tight. See, it's a bit of a fine tuning. Close it, and now we should see here, I spin this. It's good. It spins freely, and it doesn't rub on this knob. Now that this is closed and we know it's seated properly, we're gonna then run it through the sound reader, which this is the sound reader right here. It reads the optical soundtrack. And it's gonna go around. Pull back through and see it's nice and around this wheel and comes back. And we're gonna put it into this next shoe right here. Same thing as before and close it. Now notice how it's touching. We don't want this. We need to open that back up and pull it through some more. We want to make sure it's not too tight. See how taut that is? It looks like it's going to break. No. We want in the middle. Something like that. Now it's snapped in over here. We close it. If we pinch it, they're not rubbing against each other. And you can see we're not at its full tension. So this is perfect. Looks great. We're going to then move on to going around this wheel right here. Then we're going to pull it across and make sure as we pull it across it goes over this right there. We don't want it rubbing on there because that'll rub and can damage the film. Then we pull it. Let's just make this a little better. We pull it around here so it's nice and taut. We need to make sure this is up, and I switched projectors, so I got to get a take-up reel. Just take it off the arm right here. We should have done this already, but in this case, not bad. Locked in. And now we do the final step, which is we make sure this film touches the reel. In this case, I actually did not get enough slack. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna push the advance button here, and I'll put a picture of it a little bit. My hand should not be in there, I apologize for that. Push a little bit to feed a little more. Perfect. And then we put some tape on. It should feel nice and taut.
Once it's nice and taut, we do double check it over. If you can see, we have a threading diagram here if you ever need assistance. And we check over, shoes are closed, 1, 2. Check the shoe is closed up here. Nice. Loop is good. In goes, we can see everything goes over properly. It goes under this. And then we do a little trial film advance. And then we see it's spinning.
Please excuse me, but the last video was recorded a few weeks before the next part of this video. So everything up until the threading was recorded at one point, and so now everything else being recorded, this is about a month later. Operation of the 16mm projector is very straightforward. We have the knob here, which controls speed and light. So I'll show you this one. So off is off. Motor turns on the motor, but no light. Lamp turns on the light. And then off turns it off. That's pretty basic. Reverse moves the motor in reverse. I use this if you want to rewind for some reason. I don't really know. I don't really use it. And then rewind is when I show you how to rewind. It's the what we put in to rewind the film at the end. Other things we have here, mag opt setting. So this is a knob. It's pretty chunky. It's nice. Turn it one way. Click. Click. Optical is what 99% of all 16 was recorded on. That's the optical track. Magnetic is basically the same thing as a cassette, just embedded on the 16. We only really have one thing on that, so it's almost always an optical. The other three we don't have to worry about. Only the head projectionists would need to worry about this, but I'll tell you what they do anyway. Volume here is the volume. We control this through the CB650 though, so you don't have to worry about that. Treble is the treble, and bass is the bass. So these are audio controls down here. Let me adjust this. Right here is power, so off and on. And right here is the current adjust for the lamp. So if we turn on the lamp, you'll see that glow. This adjusts how much current, and you can see the little knob down there. Basically brighter versus less bright. This lamp begins to the end of its age, so it's now brighter. Okay, this knob right there
This knob is the focus knob, so you see how it moves the lens in and out? As the video is playing, as the film is playing, you'll adjust this and adjust until it gets focused and you don't have to squint. That's really it for, oh, and the change will run, of course, sorry. I almost forgot that one. This beautiful bar right there, let me see if I can get close. Ooh, yes I can. Changeover. Ah, oh, look at that beautiful button. Both of these projectors have a changeover button. You push the button, you hear that click. Now this projector is active. This is P2, or in this case, 16mm projector 2. Then on the other projector, you push it, you hear that click. That means that projector is active. So I click this again. This one's active, but I can't click it more than one time because it's now active, and it stays active until the other one's pushed, like that. You want to use a changeover because when the motor first starts up, you'll hear a warping sound, and I'll probably attach a video of a warping sound going on, and you don't want to show that to the audience. So what the changeover does is it allows for the light and sound not to be running or showing until it's pushed. So when you turn on the motor and light, it'll turn on, and once it speeds up fully, and you can even count down the header if you wish, you didn't push changeover, and you're now active and showing the film. Okay, now that everything, now you know how to use the machine, it's time to do it. So we go to lamp on. Actually, no, I'm gonna show you how to do it wrong, and we're gonna have it changed over. You'll actually, in fact, I'll just force advance with the advance button over here. You'll hear the sound. You hear that? That little scratching, whoa, pop. We don't want that. So what we would do is change over. And we go to full lamp. And now we hit change over. And now we focus. And there we go. Nah, should have changed over there. So you go. Goes to reverse. Thing there is to learn about 60mm film is how to rewind it. So I'm going to show you how to rewind it as if we stopped mid-showing, because this is a long film and I won't do that. First, I'm going to show you the steps here, and I'm going to tell you where it stops for if you're just rewinding it if it finished. So the only real difference is we got to take everything out that we threaded up before, because we don't want to rewind it through the entire machine, because that doesn't make sense and it'll take a lot more time. So once it's all out, this is basically equivalent to what it'll be like when the film ends. It's just going to be flapping at the end. So what we want to do is we want to take the film and thread it back from here and the back from the take-up reel. You want to thread it through the two wheels here, keeping the tension as before, over again, and lastly through the white pulley wheel over here. After this, we don't go through any of the threading we did before, and instead we skip right over to the reel, the actual reel it came off of. And we just make sure it goes counterclockwise here, and once this is all good and checked over, we just go to rewind. It'll take a second, and then it'll start speeding up. And you just let it run. Once it's done, it'll start flapping, in which case you then turn off the machine. Alright, it's... See, it's not flapping, and we can hit off. This one will spin down first, and we'll let this one finish spinning. And once that's good, we take it off and put it back where we found it. After putting this away, we just simply close everything, turn it off, and cover it up. That's how you use 16mm film projector.
And that's the end of the pit two. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Peace out.